In previous class, I have explained that is one marks and multiple choice questions. Today in this class, I am going to explain you that is two marks in the forms of business organization. From this chapter, you will get 1-2 marks in the examination. That question number will be 14th in the final examination. Let us start with our revision of 2 marks. Here, that first question. State any 2 merits of sole proprietorship. You have learned sole proprietorship. Here they are asking advantages or merits of sole proprietorship. Generally, the sole proprietorship you can easily start, that is easy of formation and closure and quick decision making. These are the 2 advantages of sole proprietorship. And second question, specify any 2 demerits of sole proprietorship, that is disadvantages of sole proprietorship. Here, that first one, limited resources. Second one, unlimited liability. And also, other than this, you can also write it lack of managerial skill and lack of business continuity. Next question, give the meaning of Hindu undivided family business. You have learned this is the 3rd form of business organization. In the forms of business organization, the Hindu undivided family means the owned are all the decisions here taken by the Karta. This is called Hindu undivided family business in general word. Coming to that formal meaning or formal word, 3 generation of male members living under one roof is called Hindu undivided family business, or else another meaning, it refers to form of business organization wherein the business is owned, carried by the members of Hindu undivided family business. That means this particular form of business organization, the family members will going to carry the Hindu undivided family business and all the decisions is taken by the family members. This kind of business we can call it as Hindu undivided family business. You can write it any one among that one what I have explained before that. And next one, define partnership. I already explained that is, if they ask define, you have to keep it in mind the 2 points. One is the who has given the definition and what the definition has saying. These 2 things you have to write in examination compulsory. Here, any definition, it may start according to, that means according to the Indian Partnership Act 1932 defines partnership as the relation between persons who have agreed to share the profit of the business carried by all or any one of them acting for all. That means this definition is given by Indian Partnership Act 1932, and this definition has saying that if you want to consider that partnership firm, that means they should have that relation between the 2 persons. They all are agreed to share that profit and even if that losses, and also among that partners, one partner will going to acting. That means they are going to take in the business decision, that is active partner. This is called partnership according to Act. Next one, partnership deed. That is question number 5. The partnership deed, if you want to start or if you want to form the partnership form, before you have to make a partnership deed. What is that partnership deed? It is a written agreement which contains terms and condition. This partnership deed, we can use it in only partnership firm. It is called partnership deed. Next one, question number 6. State any 2 content of partnership deed. In this document, they have some content. Here, just I have given the example, name of the firm, nature of business and location of business. Other than this, you can also write it sharing of profit and losses and the proportion of capital invested by the partners and dissolution of the partnership firm and all other factors. You can write it any 2 factors or any 2 content in the examination. Each point carries 1 marks in the examination. Next one, what is particular partnership? That means this all that partnership we can classified on types of partnership. First one, particular partnership. This particular partnership formed particular venture objectives, it is called particular partnership. That means this kind of partnership we can form on particularly to start up or to close up the business. It is called particular partnership. For example, if you want to construct a building, or on particular time you are going to making a agreement. After that constructing of on a building, that agreement or that kind of particular partnership will not continue for a long period of time. This is the best example for particular partnership. After that, there is no continuation for the business. It is called particular partnership. Next one, partnership at will. That means this is contract between the partners, and this we can be seen in the types of partnership on the basis of the time or duration. That means all the partner, they are going to carrying a business. For example, Ramesh, Suresh and Mahesh carrying the business. Mahesh, they don't want to continue the partnership form, or they don't have an interest to continue the partnership form. So Mahesh will going to give a letter. That means they are going to withdrawing the partnership from other two partners. They are going to continue the business. It is called partnership at will. Next one, general partnership. That means general partnership, as it is, all the partner, they are going to investing the capital, sharing the profit and losses. All the partner, the liability status is unlimited. It is called general partnership. Next one, unlimited liability. You have seen that the different forms of business organization having the liability status. What is called unlimited liability? That means if the person, they are not paying the loan, or they don't have a sufficient fund to clear the loan on that time, the person, he or she may sell his personal assets. He has to or she has to clear the loan or a debt. It is called unlimited liability. And next one, state any two consequences of non-registered or non-registration of partnership firm. That means if you're not registered, if you're not getting registered, what are the disadvantage you have? Suppose, for example, the firm cannot file a suit against third party. That means if you're not registered the partnership firm, you cannot put a case against third party. And next, the firm cannot file against the partner. Even the three partners, they are going to carry the partnership firm, even if that they are not registered firm, registered partnership firm, among that any conflict or misunderstanding may arise on that time. Among them partners, are one partner cannot put the case against another partner. These are the consequences of non-registered firm. Next one, 12th question, give the meaning of cooperative society. The cooperative society is a voluntary association of person who join together with the motive of welfare of the members. It is called cooperative society. And next, minimum and maximum members of cooperative society. I already explained that is cooperative society. Here the minimum member is 10, maximum is unlimited. And next, state any two types of cooperative society. In cooperative society, we have the totally six types of cooperative society. One is consumer cooperative society, second one producers cooperative society, and third one marketing cooperative society, fourth one farmers cooperative society, fifth one credit cooperative society, and last one cooperative housing society. Among this, you can write it any 2 points in the examination. Each point carries 1 marks. And next, give the meaning of joint stock company. If you want to learn the joint stock company, keep it in mind only the 4 points. These 4 points also will come for the features for a joint stock company. What are the 4 points? A company should have that artificial person. Artificial person, number one. Second one, separate legal entity. Point number three, perceptual succession and common seal. If you are remembering this 4 point, you can call it as a joint stock company. And next, question number 16, define joint stock company. I already explained, that is, if they ask define, you have to write the author or the particular act name and what that act or what that author has saying about the topic or content. Here, according to Professor Haney, the Haney has given the definition regarding to joint stock company. What is joint stock company here? The joint stock company is a voluntary association of individual for profit, having a capital divided into transferable shares, the ownership of which is the condition of membership. That means a joint stock company, it is a voluntary association. That means anyone can come and they can join to the joint stock company. There is no discrimination. They not make a discrimination of gender discrimination or color discrimination or caste discrimination. Anyone can come their own interest to the joint stock company. How they're going to come? By purchasing the shares. That means joint stock company, they are going to collecting the capital by issuing the shares to the public. The public, they're going to subscribe the shares. After, they'll become shareholders for a company. The shareholders company, we can also call it as the owners of the company. The main objective of the joint stock company is making profit or earning of profit. And also, which is condition of membership, the ownership. That means if you want to see that a owner of a company, you have to purchase or you have to subscribe the shares. Even if the shares, we have the equity shares and preference shares. I will explain more about the equity shares and preference shares in the chapter number 8, that is sources of business finance. And next question, question number 17, state the future of private company. That means in joint stock company, they have the two types of company. One is private company and public company. Here, features of private company. Here I have given, it restricts the right of members to transfer its shares. That means there is no transfer of shares from one person to another person. They have that restriction. And next, it does not invite the public to subscribe its share capital. That means if you want to start the private company, you are not going to issuing the shares to subscribe the shares to the public. Understood? And also, other than this, you can also write it, the capital investment is 1 lakh rupees and directors is one director and index. That means the private company, they will not issue that index. And next one, question number 18, state any two features of public company. Here, first feature is it has no restriction on transfer of shares. Second one, it invites public to subscribe its share capital. That means first one, it explains, that is, you can or you have the shares, you have subscribed the shares in public company, you can transfer the shares from one person to another person. There is no restriction while you are transferring in public company. Second one, it invites the public to subscribe. That means if you want to start the public company, you have to issue the shares to the public. You are going to collecting the capital from the public itself only by issuing the shares. And the last question in the 2 marks, that is, state any two differences between public company and private company. Here I already explained, that is, if you want to write it any differences in the PUC, PU level or class 12, you have to write it in this form only, that is, basis and public company and private company. On the basis itself only, you can easily write it the differences. Here, that first basis is members. See that in members in the public company, minimum is 7 and maximum is unlimited.
private company, minimum is 2, maximum is 200. And also keep it in mind, when coming to the members point, you have to keep it in mind maximum and minimum, or minimum and maximum members in both the company. And next, minimum number of directors. In public company, the directors will be 3. That means one will be woman director and rest of the two will be male or men director. And next, private company is 2 directors. And next, minimum paid up capital. If you want to start the public company, you have to be invest or you have to be collect the capital by issuing the shares, that is 5 lakh rupees, and private company 1 lakh rupees. Next one, index of members. That means the public company, they want to be having that index. Index is nothing but in stock market or share market, they are going to showing that their prices in the market. The public or other shareholders can see that prices, what is the increases or decreases of the prices in the share market or stock market. Here the stock market, we have that SEBI, Securities Exchange and Board of India. It is situated in the New Delhi. And index, here public company compulsory, private company not compulsory. And last basis is transfer of shares. In public company, there is no restriction. Private company, they have some restriction. These are the 2 marks questions. In this 2 marks questions, you can expect 1 question for the examination. In the next class, I'm going to explaining you, that is, we're going to revise 8 marks question in the second chapter. Ivattina motivational story. This story, ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ಇನ್ಸ್ಪಿರೇಷನ್ ಕೊಡುವಂಥ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಲೈಫಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕಾಗೋಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಸುಮ್ಮನೆ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಬಿಡ್ತೀವಿ, ಬಟ್ ಈ ಸ್ಟೋರಿನ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ನಾವು ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೈರ್ ಆಗ್ತೀವಿ. ಏನು ಈ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ, ಎಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆದಿದೆ ಈ ಸ್ಟೋರಿ, ಬನ್ನಿ ಕೇಳೋಣ. US ಕಂಟ್ರಿಲಿ ಒಂದು ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಹಸ್ಬೆಂಡ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೈಫು, ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಒಂದು ಚಿಕ್ಕ ಪುಟಾಣಿ ಮಗು ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಮಗು ಹುಟ್ಟದಾಗ್ನಿಂದನೇ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಿಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಆಗಿ ಹುಟ್ಟುಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಈ ಮಗುನ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆ ಹಾಸ್ಪಿಟಲಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸ್ತಾರೆ, ಬಟ್ ಅವರು ಹೇಳೋದೇನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಹುಟ್ಟಿದಾಗಿಂದನೇ ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಿಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ ಮಗು, ಇದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಸರಿ ಮಾಡೋದು ಭಾಳ ಕಷ್ಟ ಇದೆ. ಯಾಕೆಂದರೆ ಮಗು ಕುತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕೂ ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಮತ್ತು ಕಾಲು ತುಂಬ ಸ್ವಾಧೀನ, ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಆದ್ದರಿಂದ ಡಾಕ್ಟರು ಕೂಡ ಸಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದೇನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, ಈ ಮಗುನ ನೀವು ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಡಾಲ್ ಆಗಿ ನೋಡ್ಕೋಬೇಕು, ಗೊಂಬೆಯಾಗಿ ನೋಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ನೋಡಿ, ಆ ಥರ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಪೇಯ್ನ್ ಆಗ್ಬೋದು ಅಂತ. ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ಅವರು ಯಾರೂ ಕೂಡ ಈ ಮಗು ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಾಗತ್ತೆ, ಹುಷಾರಾಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಯಾರೂ ಕೂಡ ಹೇಳೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಮಗುನ ಮನೆಗೆ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಒಂದು ರೂಮಲ್ಲಿ ಆ ಮಗುನ ಡಾಲ್ ಥರ, ಅಂದರೆ ಗೊಂಬೆ ಥರ ಒಂದು ಬೆಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಮಲಗಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ ಮಗುಗೆ ಏನು ಬೇಕು, ಊಟ ತಿಂಡಿ ಇದೇ ಥರ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ ಮಗು ಒಂದು 10 ವರ್ಷ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಆ ಮಗು ದೊಡ್ಡೋದಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಆವಾಗಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಆ ಮಗುಗೆ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕಾಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಕೂಡ ನಿದ್ದೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರತ್ತೆ, ಯಾರಾದರೂ ಆ ಮಗುನ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕಿರಬೇಕು. ಬಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸು ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಅದರಿಂದ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಆ ಮಗುನ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಭಾಳ ಕಷ್ಟ ಆಗ್ತಿರತ್ತೆ. ಅದರಿಂದ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಆ ಮಗುಗೆ ಏನೇನು ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕೋ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕೈಗೆ ಸಿಗಬೇಕು ಆ ಥರ ಎತ್ತಿಟ್ಟಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ ರೂಮಲ್ಲಿ ಮಗು ಒಬ್ಬಳೇ ಇರ್ತಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ, ಹುಡುಗಿ ಒಬ್ಬಳೇ ಇರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಭಾಳ ಬೇಜಾರಾಗ್ತಿತ್ತು. ಅಪ್ಪ ಅಮ್ಮ ಕೂಡ ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗ್ತಿದ್ರು. ಇವರು ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗೋದನ್ನ ನೋಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಒಂದಿನ ಆ ಮಗು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತು, ಮೆಲ್ಲಗೆ ಹೇಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಇದೇ ಥರ ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಡೇ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಬಿದ್ದೋಯ್ತು. ಅವ್ರ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸು ಸಂಜೆ ಬಂದು ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಮಗು ಬೆಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಎಲ್ಲೋಯ್ತು ಮಗು ಅಂತ ನೋಡಿದಾಗ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಬಿದ್ದೋಗಿದ್ದಾಳೆ. ಆಗಾಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಆ ಮಗುನ ಮತ್ತೆ ಬೆಡ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಮಲಗಿಸಿದ್ರು. ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಇದೇ ಥರ ಮಗು ಎದ್ದೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಒಂದು ತುಂಬ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಛಲ ಇತ್ತು. ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ ಪಾಪ ಮಗು, ಈಗಷ್ಟೇ ಎದ್ದೊಳನ, ಏನು ಏನು ಆಗೋದಿಲ್ವ ನನ್ನ ಕೈಯಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ ಆ ಮಗುಗೆ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೈರ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಡೇ 2 ಅಂದರೆ ಅಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪ ಮತ್ತೆ ಕೆಲಸಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದರು. ಮಗು ಎದ್ದೋಳಿ ನಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಒಂಚೂರು ಟ್ರೈ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಮತ್ತೆ ಕೆಳಗಡೆ ಬಿತ್ತು. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಿಟಕಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಕಂಬಿಗಳಿರುತ್ತಲ್ವ, ಆ ಕಂಬಿನ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ನಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಎದ್ದೊಳ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸಂಜೆ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತು ನಿಧಾನಕ್ಕೆ ಅಷ್ಟೊತ್ತಿಗೆ ಹೋಗಿ ನಿದ್ದೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ಲು. ಮತ್ತು ಇದೇ ಥರ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಡೇ ಇದೇ ಥರ ಎಷ್ಟೋ ದಿನ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಅದೇ ಥರ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ಲು. ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ 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 ಒಂಚೂರು ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಆಯಿತು. ಇದೇ ಥರ ನಡೆಯೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಲು. ನಡೆಯೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಒಂಚೂರು ಸ್ಟಾಮಿನಾ ಬಂತು. ಸ್ಟಾಮಿನಾ ಬಂದ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಈ ವಿಷಯ ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಯಿತು. ಆಗ ಇವರು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ನ ಕನ್ಸಲ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ನ ಕನ್ಸಲ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ನಮ್ಮ ಮಗು ಈಗ ಒಂಚೂರು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡ್ರೆ, ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟರೆ ನಿಂತ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಡಾಕ್ಟರು ಒಂದು ಸಜೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಹೌದಾ, ಹಾಗಾದರೆ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಈ ಮಗುನ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಕೊಡಿಸಿ, ಅಂದರೆ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ಗೆ ಹಾಕಿ ಅವರು ಟ್ರೈನಿಂಗ್ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುತ್ತೆ. ಹೇಳಾದ್ಮೇಲೆ ಇವ್ರು ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸು ಆ ಮಗುನ ಸ್ಪೆಷಲ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ಸ್ಗೆ ಕಳಿಸ್ತಾರೆ. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಮಗುಗೆ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಳ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇತ್ತು, ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ಕಿಂತ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಳ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಇತ್ತು. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪಿ ಟಿ ಮಾಸ್ಟರ್ ಇದ್ದರು, ಆ ಪಿ ಟಿ ಮಾಸ್ಟ್ರು ಈ ಮಗುಗೆ ತುಂಬ ಎಂಕರೇಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾಯಿದ್ರು, ಸಿಕ್ಕಾಪಟ್ಟೆ ಎಂಕರೇಜ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾಯಿದ್ರು. ತನ್ನ ಸ್ವಂತ ಮಗಳ ಥರ ಅವಳನ್ನ ನೋಡ್ಕೊಳ್ತಿದ್ರು. ಆಯಿತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಈ ಮಗು ಅಥ್ಲೆಟಿಕ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸ್ಪೋರ್ಟ್ಸಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಭಾಳ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಆಗಿ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾಯಿದ್ರು. ಈ ಮಗುನ ನೋಡಿದ ತಕ್ಷಣ ಒಂಚೂರು ಒಂದು ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ವರ್ಷಗಳ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಸೇಮ್ ಪಿ ಟಿ ಮಾಸ್ಟ್ರು ಆ ಮಗುನ ನೋಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಈ ಮಗು ಏನಾದರೂ ಲೈಫಲ್ಲಿ ಅಚೀವ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಆಗಸ್ಟೇ ಒಲಂಪಿಕ್ಸು ಬರುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಒಲಂಪಿಕ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಈ ಮಗುಗೆ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಿಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನಿಂದ ಅಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಹಾಕ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಿಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಮಗು ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಒಲಂಪಿಕ್ಗೆ. ಒಲಂಪಿಕ್ಗೆ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಈವೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಂಥ ಎಲ್ಲ ಈವೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಯು ಎಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿನ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. ಆ ಮಗು ಯು ಎಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿನ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಈವೆಂಟಲ್ಲೂ ಕೂಡ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಡಲನ್ನು ತಗೊಳುತ್ತೆ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಡಲ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಆರ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೆಡಲ್ ಒಲಂಪಿಕ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ತೊಗೊಂಡಿರುವಂಥ ಕಂಟ್ರಿ ಯು ಎಸ್, ಈ ಅದರಲ್ಲೂ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡಿಕ್ಯಾಪ್ ಗ್ರೂಪಿಂದ. ಅಂದರೆ ನಾನು ಯಾರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂತ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವೇ ಗೆಸ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಯು ಎಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರಿಯಿಂದ ಮೊದಲ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಸಿಪೇಂಟ್ ಒಲಂಪಿಕ್ಗೆ ಇವಳು ಅಥವಾ ಇವಳ ಹೆಸರೇನು ಅಂತ ನೀವು ಕಂಡಿಡ್ದು ನನಗೆ ಕಮೆಂಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ. ಈ ಮಗು ನಮಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಕೂಡ ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೈರು. ಯಾಕೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡೋಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ನೋದಕ್ಕಿಂತ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಇನ್ಸ್ಪೈರ್ ತುಂಬಬೇಕು, ಅಂದರೆ ಮೋಟಿವೇಷನ್ ಇರಬೇಕು ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ. ಮೋಟಿವೇಷನ್ ಇರಲಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಈ ಕಥೆಯನ್ನು ಮುಗಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ.